About 4 years ago, I was sitting in a Methodist church, and was I ready for Jesus to be in my life then? No, because I was sitting there at the top of an altar call, and I was sitting there, and I broke out in a sweat. My head was sweating. I was hot, and I was like, no, I can't go up there because I still need to fix something. And about a year later, we're sitting down here. And Pastor Bob did an altar call, and I started getting that feeling again. You know, it had been a year, and I hadn't fixed anything. I was still doing the same stuff I was doing before. Going out drinking, partying, not doing what I should be doing. And I knew if I wanted to repair my own relationship with my children, that I needed to stop. So I came forward. I think Mike was the first one to come here. I came forward up here. And then a couple other friends, Jamie and her dad, Doug, came forward and prayed for me as well. And from that day forward, it was a relief. So
that kind of starts us in a nice one. How did it feel once you finally made that decision?
Well, I was relieved. It took a big, heavy weight off my heart. I had a heart of stone. Felt to change that day, but my heart wasn't softened.
Has there been any one person that's really helped you down that journey?
I hate to be repetitive, but without him, I probably would have never gone back to church. I never went to church as a kid growing up. I never really went to church as an adult, except to get out of work when I was in the Army. Then, you know, you go to church on Sunday, you didn't have to go to work. And when my son passed away in 2001, I completely quit going to church. We used to go for special occasions like, you know, Good Friday, Easter, Christmas. But I just quit going completely. I was heartbroken.
So how do you feel you've changed? What do you think about a couple key things that have changed in your life since?
Well, my heart is no longer a stone. I became a better person, more caring person. Last summer, my ex-wife got sick with leukemia, and her and I were not friends. We were not even remotely friendly. But when she called me and told me that she had leukemia, I felt that I had to help her. And it wasn't that I had to. I felt that God was pushing me to be there for her and my children. So I'm just a much happier, softer, gentler man.
Last question. What are you excited about from this point on?
Well, I'm praying that God will use me as a light to shine on my children and my grandchildren and some of my other family members that need to find Jesus. And, you know, if he would just use me, that would be a wonderful deal.
Awesome. Let's give them all a round of applause.